Well, hi, it's Rod Miller from Pacific Residential Mortgage with my three-pointer of the week. Another installment in my weekly video series where I talk about 3 points related to the real estate and mortgage industries to help keep real estate agents informed on current topics and equip them to serve their clients at the highest level. Point one, a number of weeks ago, I shared the news that FHA was going to allow what are called spot condo approvals. This is where a single condo unit in a non-FHA approved project could be approved for financing if it met certain conditions. The effective date for this decision was October 15th, so it's now available. However, we're not expecting this to be a quick process since all of the spot approvals will actually be approved by FHA after a review of various documentation. So we're expecting a multi-week process, especially at the beginning as this process gets underway. But it's just really hard to know what this process will look like. So if you happen to have a client involved in one of these transactions, I'd adjust expectations, plan for maybe a 60-day closing period at the minimum. But once we get a few of these under our belt, we'll be able to get a better feel for how much time this will take. But I think it's probably prudent to plan for the worst and hope for the best at this point in time. Point two, here's a refresher for you on the difference between the note rate and the annual percentage rate, or APR. Note rate is used to calculate the monthly mortgage payment, and it appears on the promissory note that the borrower signs at closing, hence the term note rate. The APR, on the other hand, is simply a disclosure rate that was created to provide some method of identifying the overall cost of borrowing based upon some given assumptions. APR, the calculation, incorporates all the financing costs that are paid by the borrower over the life of the loan. So these costs include certain fees paid at closing, such as origination fees, discount points, escrow fee, and a few others. And if the loan happens to have mortgage insurance, then those premiums are also included in the APR calculation too. APR, it assumes that the mortgage will be in place for the full term of the loan, so typically 30 or 15 years depending on the product. And this is why comparing APRs as a basis for selecting the best loan is a faulty methodology, because we all know that very, very few loans last the full term of the loan. So, for example, you could obtain a low APR by agreeing to pay 2 or 3 discount points at closing. But if your intentions are to sell the home or refinance it in 3 to 5 years, then you'd be better off not paying those points, accepting a slightly higher rate, and your APR would be a little bit higher as well. But because your overall cost of financing will be less over that length of time, the APR is irrelevant. It's always why we tell our clients that the lowest rate with the wrong strategy can actually cost you more than a slightly higher rate with the correct strategy. So the goal of the APR is noble, but in practice it falls short of being a useful tool for comparing financing options. And finally, I think most people are familiar with the following quote from Henry Ford, in which he famously said, "If you think you can do a thing, or you think you can't do a thing, you're right." It really speaks to the power of our mindset. But he has a number of other impactful statements, and what I'm going to share with you, I think, is really powerful. And it goes like this: failure is simply the opportunity to begin again, this time more intelligently. Now, isn't that a great way to view failure? It's not permanent, it's not fatal, it's just an opportunity to learn and do it better the next time. So, very powerful. That's it for this week's video. I hope you enjoy the weekend. And remember, you can't hit the shots you don't take, so get in the game, call for the ball, take your best shot.